Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. So in continuation with the previous video on the design problem of steel bridge or truss bridge garden, in the previous video we have discussed about the how other aspects like the calculation of the ILD part, drawing the ILDs, finding out the areas and calculation of the live load, dead load and the impact load, and finding out the design forces in each of these members. So in this video we'll discuss about the designing part. Okay, how the members, once the forces are known, how the members will be designed, that will be discussed. So as in the previous video I've discussed about four members, one top chord member, one bottom chord member, one diagonal member and one vertical member. So the first one was the top chord member, which was carrying compressive force. So the design force in this member was 3892.5 kN. That was compressive. Length of the member is 4 meter, that is 4000 millimeter. Okay. Now let us find what is the area required for this member. Okay. So this is the load and sigma SE. Let us take sigma SE as 110. You can take this value up to 150 permissible stress in compressive force. Compression is 150, so up to 150 you can take. We have taken 110. This is the usual value that we take. So this yields us an area of 353.8386.36. So this much area we have to provide in this compression area. Now since it's a truss gauge bridge, a single I section would not be sufficient. So the choice of the section is dependent. The choice of the section is up to the designer. Okay, whatever the designer feels suitable, but it should meet the area requirements first. So here we have selected two I section along with one cover plates. You can also select two I section and check the load carrying capacity. Fails, then you can go for one cover plate. If it fails, if it even fails in one cover plate, provide another cover plate. Okay, so we have to check. So this is the section that we have chosen. So this consists of two ISLB, okay, 600, and on the top flange of these two ISLB we have placed a cover plate having thickness of 22 mm and width of 500 mm. Okay, so now let us find what is the moment of inertia of this. Okay, now see, these are two I sections and this is on top placed with one flange cover plate. Okay, top flange cover plate. Now moment of inertia will be Iyy of this. So we are calculating first Iyy. Okay. So Iyy of this value, ISLB, this we get from steel table, this value, plus area of this section, area of this I section. Okay. Into. Now for this two section, obviously the CG will be along this line. Y axis will be along this line. Okay. Somewhere in the center of these two I sections. So this, and you have to find what is the distance of, this is the CG, this distance to this distance we need to find. So this will be from here to here, entire is 500. Okay, so from here to here, the center of the CG line, y axis line to the end plate, it will be 500 by 2 minus this distance, the breadth of the flange for this section is 210. So if the breadth of the flange is 210, so from here to here it will be 210 by 2. So from here to here you will get the value. So this is 500 by 2 minus 210 by 2 whole square. This is by applying the parallaxis theorem, plus the moment of inertia of the plate about this, of this flange cover plate about the y axis. So this is 22 into 500 cube by 12. So this gives us Iyy as 79833.6. okay. Similarly, you can also find IXX. The member having the least radius of gyration will be along the axis which carries the least moment of inertia. So for IYY it is 79833.6 into 10 to the power 4. Area you know, then find what is RYY. So from this value, RYY is root IYY by A. So it comes out to be 148.22. So now for this, you find what is the you know what is RYY, okay, you know what is L, then now find out what is the slenderness ratio of the member. Okay, once you find the slenderness ratio, then what you do is you find from the tables the value of sigma IC. Once you know sigma IC and you know what is the area provided to be area of this plus this, then you find sigma IC into the area with the load carried by this member, and this load carried by the member should be higher than this design force. If it is higher, then this section is okay. So this is how we design a compressive member. This, you know, basic fundamentals of design of a compression member. Now for this member, now another thing that I want to discuss here is here we have designed using WSM methods, but since all our students are well versed with the limit state method, so you can go with your limit state method of conventional limit state method of design also. Okay, but in bridges this here it is done by WSM method. So now for this member U2L3, so this is a diagonal member. So see what is the tensile force here. The tensile force is this much and compressive. Now in the earlier video we have discussed that the diagonal member and the vertical member will consist of both the tensile, will carry both tensile force and compressive force. So you have to check the member as a compression member and tensile member. So both these checks has to be done. So now what we are doing is checking is at as a tension member. So what is the length of the member? Width was, span to span spacing was, panel spacing was 4 meter, height was 4 meters. So diagonal member length will be root over 4 square plus 4, 5.656. This is the length. Now let us try 4 sections, okay, 4 channel sections, angle sections, sorry, of these angles 125 by 95 by 10. So this is an unequal leg angle, so we are arranging these angles in this fashion. Okay, now these angles are laced, this and this angle are laced, and this angle is laced. The lacing is done on both the sides. Okay, now this angle is connected by 6 rivets. So one rivet here, one rivet here, one rivet here, and one rivet here, and this back to back, these two legs are also connected by these two rivets. So there are a total of 6 rivets that will be weakened by 6 holes. Now for this angle, what is the gross area? 4 into 2102, which is obtained from steel tool. This is the gross area. Now what will be the net area then? This area minus 6 into 21.5. What is this 21.5? This is nominal dia of the bore of the hole. So this is 20 mm dia rivets are taken or bolts are taken. So it is 21.5, 6 into 10. So this gives us 7118 mm². Our record area was 7112, and the area that we have provided is 7118. So this is all right. Area is correct. So it is safe in tension. So it can carry the tension force. This member can, design member can carry the requisite force. Now we'll design it, check for it as a compression member. So find what is IXX. So IXX is 4 times the IXX plus your CG of this section will lie somewhere here. Okay, this CG will be here. Your CG of the section will be here. Okay, so you know 4XX plus this distance. This distance is how much? C, your this distance is CXX. So CXX is 38.8. So 4 into area into CXX. Parallax theorem, this gives us IXX. Similarly, you find IYY for this. So IYY will be here to that distance. Okay. IYY will be 4 into this, 4 into this individual moment of inertia of all the IYY of all the 4 angles plus 4 times area into here to here distance. Okay, so this distance is from here to here, it is 250 by 2, and this distance is how much? From the x-axis, this distance is how much? This is 23.9. So this value will give you this distance. That minus this is this distance. This distance you need to find. So you are, so then you have your IYY. So IYY is greater than IXX. Okay. So you find IXX is least. So bending will be about IXX. So find RXX. RXX is root IYA. So this gives us 55.27. So find lambda. Lambda is, in this case, lambda is 0.8 times K in L by R. So K is 0.85, L by R, R is this. So this gives us 86.98. Lambda, for lambda 86.98, Fi 250 from the table we get lambda sigma ics 93.32. So the load carrying capacity will be this sigma ic into a. Okay, so this gives us as 784.64. It is more than 412.58. So this section is okay. So this is safe in compression members. So this is how your one of the diagonal members design is complete. Similarly, for the other vertical member, which is carrying a compressive force of 288.07 and tensile force of 75.42 kN, you have to design similarly. You take another four angles and you check what is the, in the same manner like in the previous member, you check what is the compressive load carrying capacity. Same way you find IXX, you find IYY, find RXX, find lambda, and then find what is the, once you know lambda, you find sigma ic from the curve and then find the load carrying capacity. So here in this case, load carrying capacity is this much, 750.97 kN, which is greater than 288 this compressive force. So it is, this compressive member check has been done. So now you have to check by tension members. So as a tension members, same way, six holes are there. So area what you have provided, net area will be gross area minus 4 times the 4 d into t. So d is 21.5, d thickness of these angles are 18 mm. Okay. So this holds, this is 5120. So load cabin capacity, this into sigma ic, take sigma ic as 150. Okay. Here you are taking sigma ic as for tension, sigma at, it's not ac, sigma at is axial stress in tension, that is 150. So this gives us a 768, which is greater than 750. So it is all right. So it is all right in tension, compression and tension members. Both the forces, it is safe. Now the last member, which is the member L2, L3. This is the bottom chord member. So it will carry only tensile force, that is 3460. So length is, for this is 4 meter. So what is the area required? Find out what is the area required. This by sigma at you take as 150, that is uniform. Okay, compression, for compressive members takes, you can decrease the sigma ic, but here you will take for sigma at values, you take 150 as 150. So this gives us the net area required is this much. Again, using you, now we have what is the net area required. Now you select one section, this is ISLB 450. So ISLB, these two ISLB 450 connected by a cover plate 500 into mm on the top of the two flanges. So now find what is the net area provided. Net area provided is this 2 into this area plus 500 into 20. Okay, this is the gross area. Okay, this value is the gross area minus, you are making how many holes here, okay, and here you are taking 2 holes, 2 into 20, you take 22 dia divets, then what is the this thing in WSM, it is dia plus 1.5 to 23.5 into 20. Okay, plate thickness is 20. So this gives us as net area is this much. Okay, now this net area into the sigma ic, sigma at, sigma at is 150. Now this gives us this load as load carrying capacity, tension load is 3853.2 and it is 3460. So it is greater than the design force. So it, hence it is okay, it is safe in tension. So this is how the tension member, bottom chord tension member is designed. So as you can see, if you can design one of these members, the other members will follow. Okay, you can design other parts very easily, should know the concept. And preferably here we have explained by WSM method, you can design the members using your limit state method. The only thing is that you need to know what are the design forces in each of the members. So this completes your entire design of the truss girder bridges. Thank you.